Those gingerbread went down the tree, didn't they?
That's the one that everyone's paws has been on.
How's things with talent been this week?
Yeah, good. We had a good week, yeah. One of our clients were moving closer to probably an offer. We've had three interviews this week. Well, I think we've had two, and we've had one request, which was for today.
We've got a client over in Athens now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're working on the new, sort of Athens, Edinburgh split, isn't it? It's the same network. Yeah. So, yeah, I think we're going to be busy right up until the end of 3 years. I think with everything that we've missed, it's just going to keep going. How's your week been, Joe?
Yeah, really good.
Tash is looking insane.
Quite a lot of CVs out. Obviously, lots of good feedback, I think, from the CVs we have put forward, which is nice. Yeah. And obviously, hopefully one person moving to offer stage, fingers crossed, which would be exciting, first person. But yeah, another really productive week. So yeah, I'm happy. So as long as you're happy.
Yeah. Put me on the spot. I'm happy.
Joel, I love your photos, by the way, on the Instagram.
Yeah.
Lots of good feedback from that as well. So.
And you raised quite a good amount of money as well.
For this show, I just go straight for 300. Yeah. So hopefully can make that, which would be nice. I get a free pair of November socks if I do. So.
How's your week been, Matt? All good?
Yeah, enjoyable.
Yeah.
Quite long. I used up all my energy on the last video. I can't do it.
And G, it's nice to have you back.
Yeah, who's this? Yeah,
who's this?
Do you
want to introduce yourself to the camera?
Hi, my name's George Edwards. I do work for HDE. Yeah, I've been in Birmingham Tuesday and Wednesday for a user group for customers coming in from kind of Northern Ireland, Scotland, for higher ed and local gov. And we had a whole day of kind of presenting on the Tuesday, and then I had some closed user groups on the Wednesday so they could go into a room and talk about the client, basically. Things seemed to go pretty well, so and customers were happy. So
Big well done. We had a client reach out to me and ask just to give G a huge pat on the back for all of the work she's been doing over the last few months.
That's good, yeah.
We've got three new clients that we've onboarded this week. Some marketing work and a couple of new websites which have come through from Ashley. And
we got a strategy meeting on the towards the end of the month, start of December. But we're having a massive kickoff, a four-day strategy session with the founder, the marketing teams and the sales teams, going through deal cycles, looking at developing a proper social strategy and a funnel mechanism to help them generate more leads. So that should be really interesting. And it's one client we've wanted to work with for a long, long time. So it's good that we're doing this properly and going all the way through. So
last but not least, the TechSmart website that we've been working on has finally been launched. I think we announced it yesterday. That was a beast. A beast. We've had like multiple servers crash and go down. We've got servers over in like America and in Canada that have gone bust because of this website. So it's been absolutely hectic, but yeah, we did it in the end. It was something like over 125,000 files all trying to download at the same time. Yeah, but
jeez. But he put this on.
Well, me and Shat were chatting yesterday, like, we need to tell the guys to put on the new album on Friday morning.
I mean, yeah, it's
just come out, you've got to put it on, but I get it, we need some Friday vibes.
It's just come to my attention that this man has eaten half a loaf of bread in a day.
I've had four pieces, alright? Four pieces.
I think it was six.
Yeah, good mate, really productive. Got some really good product out. Yeah, just finishing off with a couple of these.
Beautiful.
So we are here at the Engine Shed party.
Turn the camera off.
Hello, welcome.
Hey guys, Engine Shed party's out here. We will be joining it very shortly. There you go.
There you go.
All the time, non-stop.
Obviously.
Oh, go on, Nature Boy.
Jordan, Jordan. Hello, love.
Cheers.
How's your night been?
Excellent.
Sing Thriller at the end.
Could be horrendous. Could be tremendous.
So are you excited for Christmas then, Scott?
What's that? What's Christmas? I know it's yesterday, like a lot more lights have been going up where I live. In my head, I still think it's like August. Obviously the weather this week, demisting, defrosting the car in the morning. But yeah, I can't even get my head around it.
You know, your Christmas tree up then?
I absolutely love Christmas. Like genuinely, really like it. But it's just like this year, it's just gone so fast. Yeah, I need like another 4 months and then I'll be like, right, I'm ready for Christmas now.
So Scott, what is the candidate market looking like and what do you predict remote working to like in 2022?
So, really interesting at the moment. We've probably got like two ends of the spectrum in terms of candidates. So you've got a real want and need from candidates that want to be back in the workplace. So we've got a lot of candidates that are pushing for that element of having that access and having an actual hub to work from. And they feel that's where they excel best. And then on the other end of the scale, it's a modern approach to the workplace where a lot of guys have actually excelled during the pandemic and they found that they've had a nicer balance between work and life and their personal life, especially with young families and things like that. So we've got quite a few candidates and clients alike that are happy for people to be based remotely. I think into 2022, I just saw today that Atom Bank have announced that they're going down to a 4-day working week. So there is still going to be a pushback from candidates aligning to the fact that they want to be based from home. We're the guys in the middle that are trying to help our clients find the best talent, whether that's based in the Southwest. You know, we're trying to attract candidates to the Southwest as well. So we've got a lot of emerging clients now that are basing themselves here. And with that, we're trying to sell the fact that, you know, it's not just about, you know, being based remotely. You can indulge in the city of Bristol. There's a lot of things going on in the city as well that make it a fantastic place to work and live. We're trying to be an advocate and base our new marketing campaign around attracting new talent to the city and not just just relying on remote working for the next couple of years. We're trying to build that picture of a modern working Bristol.
Could you give us an idea of the type of clients you've been working with at the moment?
Yeah, of course I can. So another busy week, and it seems like every week we're sort of adding to our roster of clients, which is fantastic. We're working with, I would say, you know, anywhere from startups, scale-ups, and companies with exciting tech companies with sort of 2 to 3 heads that have grown to, you know, 10 to 15 over their first year of being incorporated, to some actual sort of multinational entities as well. So I feel that our client roster really sort of reflects who we are. So in terms of like candidates looking for work in the new year, and I would say now is the time definitely to start sort of getting in touch with us. I think the average time for permanent hires is anywhere between 4 and 6 weeks. You can pretty much sort of say 2 weeks within December are redundant because of the Christmas period and the break. But yeah, we've got a number of innovative clients that we're working with, you know, anywhere from sort of mental health focused startups, some huge e-commerce companies that we're working with, digital banking. So yeah, a real repertoire of, I would say, diverse clients that would probably tailor towards the needs of any sort of candidate, whether it's dev, whether it's marketing, whether it's sales. So yeah, I would just say to any sort of candidates that I've got one eye on the market for next year, just to reach out and have a confidential chat with us.